back in Seletar Park Residences. Let's go!
So today we are at a one-bedder in Seletar Park Residence, and before we see the rest of the house, I'll go through a little bit in terms of the layouts and the sizes that are in Seletar Park Residences. So for one-bedders here, there are basically three different sizes: 528 square feet, 582 square feet, and 593 square feet. Let's first compare the 582 and the 593 square feet floor plans. As you can see from the floor plans, they are not so different, they're actually very, very similar. The only difference is this: the extra 11 square feet of space is actually outside the door. A piece of space that you're not using 100% of the time, but you're actually paying for 100% of it, right? So if you are to compare 582 and 593 square feet, I would think that 582 square feet is actually a little bit more efficient. So now let's compare the 582 square feet and the 528 square feet layouts. If you see from the floor plans, right, there's this significant space highlighted here that is inside the 582 square feet but not existent in the 528 square feet. Why is this significant? Let me show you. The area that is behind me, right, doesn't exist in the 528 square feet. So this entire extra space actually frees up a lot of space for you to pull your dining area all the way back, and then you can do a work from home desk setup right beside your living area. And I think it's pretty good because right now we are in a very work from home kind of scenario, right? Enough about this area, let's take a look at the rest of the house. So you can see the nice thing about this one bedder is that all the storage kitchen area is actually flush to one side of the entire area. So the DB box is here, there's a lot of storage in here as well, and it links all the way to the kitchenette area. So this kitchenette area, you can see there's a lot of usable space here for your cutting, you know, preparing your vegetables whatsoever. Cooker hood and hob by SMEG, you have an oven by SMEG, even a fridge that's inbuilt also by SMEG. There's a washer dryer here. We got the dish rack, you know, a lot of storage space at the top. So other than the cooking and the baking you can do here, there's still a lot of space to store whatever you need to store here. Now enough about the kitchenette, let's move on to the living room. Living room. So this living room is really, really spacious. I don't think you can find something that's this spacious right now in the market nowadays for any new launch. This space is really big. If you compare the wall-to-wall distance, I can barely reach the other side, right? Now the next thing that you need to notice about this place is what I've mentioned in the last Seletar Park Residence video, is that there's a very, very high ceiling height. This ceiling height is 3.2 meters, which gives the entire space a lot more brightness, a lot more airiness. Is that even a word? So if you're wondering where's the balcony, it's actually just behind me, which you can access via this door. Exit to the balcony, you can actually link yourself to the master bedroom balcony, and then you can enter from there. Right, speaking of the master bedroom. Master bedroom. So the whole theme of today is talking about how big the space the entire house is. For the master bedroom, you see here, this one is a queen size bed, and it still can comfortably put a side table and a large rack right here. So if you really want, you can make this into a king size bed and still be able to put these two items here. Now, 3.2 meter ceiling, again, very high ceiling, makes it very bright and airy. And if you want, you can like add a TV here because there's a TV point here. So editor, you go and add in the TV here for me, okay? Okay, let's move on to the toilet. So one of the highlights of the entire house is this bathroom. It really mimics a hotel kind of style. As you can see, the vanity counter, the wash basin is just outside, right? You got shelving here as well as a storage area. Now, beside this is your shower toilet area. If we walk in here, there's a rain shower here. The toilet is actually on the other side, and you get windows for ventilation. It's not your typical kind of mechanical ventilation. So very convenient, right? When one of you is actually taking a shower, right? The other one can be here washing up, doing your makeup, whatsoever. Right, next, let's take a look at the wardrobe. So the wardrobe, very, very good size, you know. What a good idea. I mean, space. Okay, so, okay. Oh, I forgot to talk about the floor tiles. So the floor tiles here are marble tiling. The wall tiles are also marble tiling. Right, so the other part of the house that has marble floor tiles is the entrance area, the foyer area. What about the living dining area and the master bedroom itself? It is with timber flooring. So the entire house has very good flooring. Right? Enough about the house, let's take a look at the project and the area. So as mentioned before, Seletar Park Residence is actually in a C-shaped kind of orientation. Now all the one bedders are facing in this direction, so there is no west sun and all one bedders are in a north-south orientation. So for the facilities, starting from the clubhouse, there's the golf simulation room, a private dining area next to the function room as well, and also a reading room. Now there's also a gymnasium at the bottom of the clubhouse, which is accessible from the car park area. And from the gymnasium, when you walk out of the gymnasium, you will be able to see the sunken courtyard right next to the cascading water feature. Now when you go up from there, there's the 50 meters lap pool with cabanas at the side, seating areas at the side. So if you want to have a casual swim in the area, this will be the perfect place for you. Now opposite of the clubhouse, you will have treehouse and children's playground. Seletar Park Residence is actually nestled within a landed cluster, which is a really, really peaceful and serene area. So if you are someone that is very scared of high traffic areas or very scared of very noisy areas, this would be the perfect place for you. Immediately within the region is Greenwich V. If you need to have dining or shopping options, it's right next to you. But if you want a different choice for a mall, within a few minutes drive is the Seletar Mall next to Fernvale Station. As for the primary schools, they are within 1 kilometer of Seletar Park Residence. You have Fernvale Primary and Sengkang Green Primary. The project is also a few minutes drive to CTE, which links to TPA as well. So it's really convenient in terms of driving location. Oh. So if you like what you see today and would like an exclusive viewing of this one better, contact us and we'll arrange one just for you. This is Louis from LoukProp, and I'll see you in the next video.